Run away, chicken, Eddie Franklin. We'll see you tomorrow.
Man. Oh, man, it's good to get away from that guy. All he ever does is pick on me.
Hey, Eddie. What are you doing here? I thought we were going to meet at the library so I could, you know, help you with your math.
Oh, hey, Claire. Yeah, I guess I forgot.
Well, that's okay. We can work on it now.
No, that's okay. You know, I'm not feeling it. I'm just gonna go home. I'll see you later, okay?
Wait, what's wrong?
Well, nothing's wrong. I just gotta go.
Well, no, something's wrong, Eddie. Come on, tell me.
What are you doing? Cut it out!
Eddie, you can tell me.
Cut it out!
Eddie, come on,
Eddie. Lay off, Claire! You're not the boss of me. You can't order me around no matter what you do to me.
What?
You got it?
No matter what I do to you, Eddie, what on earth are you talking about? I didn't do anything to you. Well, I'm certainly not going to do anything for you now either. Like, help you with your math.
I didn't mean it, Claire. Really, I'm sorry.
Well, okay, apology accepted, Eddie. But what's wrong? You can tell me.
I'm just having some trouble with this kid at school.
Okay, what's going on?
That's this one kid, Robbie Jenkins.
Robbie Jenkins? Isn't he the guy that Jason was having problems with last month?
Yeah.
What's he doing now?
Oh, what isn't he doing? He takes my lunch money, he waits for me after school to beat me up, sometimes he'll get me, sometimes he won't. He pushes me around on the playground, calls me mean names, and he says, if I tell anyone, I'll be real sorry.
I'm sorry, Eddie. That stinks.
Yeah, it sure does. But the worst part of all is, I feel really guilty.
Wait, guilty? About what?
About Jason.
Why would you feel guilty about Jason? You didn't do anything.
Exactly. When Jason was the one getting picked on, I just stood around and watched while my best friend got humiliated, and I never said a word. I'm a real crummy friend.
You're not a crummy friend, Eddie.
Yes, I am. I should have done something to stop it, but I didn't. Because I was scared. And I was even glad that I wasn't the one getting picked on. But now that I am the one getting picked on and bullied, I bet all the other kids are glad they're not me. Guess I deserve it, huh?
Nobody deserves it, Eddie. Kids should feel like their school is a safe place.
Not when Robbie Jenkins goes there. Guess they'll just have to suffer through it and hope he moves on to someone else.
Is that what you really want?
No, but I don't want it happening to me either.
Well, then you've got to stop it.
Oh, yeah, right, yeah. Well, look at me, Claire. I'm a real big tough guy. Oh, I know. I'll go home and get my Halloween costume out of my closet. You know, the one with the big red cape. And I'll fly on over to Robbie Jenkins' house and beat him up.
Beat him up? Eddie, you know that violence never makes a bad situation better.
So what then?
Well, maybe you should talk to someone, you know, like an adult.
Oh, no way! I'm no tattletale!
Eddie, you know that there is a huge difference between tattling and reporting. When you tattle, yeah, you're just trying to get someone in trouble. But when you report, you're trying to keep yourself or someone else safe, and you might need an adult's help.
Yeah, I kind of tried that reporting thing. I told my teacher, Mr. Taylor.
Oh, yeah? Well, what did he say?
Well, he just kind of laughed it off and said, hang in there, Eddie. It's just a part of growing up. It'll end sooner or later.
Sounds like you picked the wrong person to report to, Eddie.
But no, I'm pretty sure Mr. Taylor's right.
He is not right. Do you think that Mr. Taylor would put up with Robbie coming into his classroom every day, beating him up and taking his lunch money?
What are you talking about, Claire? That would never happen. And besides, what do you know about it? I've never seen you get picked on.
I have too been picked on, Eddie.
Really?
Yes. Like, when I was in fifth grade, there was this group of girls that was really mean to me. They'd say rotten things right to my face, talk about me behind my back. They'd have lots of parties or get-togethers, make sure to take lots of pictures, and then they'd tag me in them all over social media. Just so I knew I hadn't been invited. I didn't know what to do.
Man, well, see, there, you couldn't do anything to stop it, and neither can I.
But that's where you're wrong, Eddie. But bullying isn't just your problem.
What do you mean?
I mean that It's not just your problem. It's everybody's responsibility to stand up to bullies. For every kid who's getting pushed around on the playground, for every kid terrified to ride the bus, for every kid having to take the long way home from school, this must stop.
Yeah, all right. But how?
Well, there are lots of different ways. Oh, like when it happened to me, you know, it bothered me for a really long time. 2 years, even after it happened.
Wow.
Yeah, so I decided I was going to write an article for my school paper to show people just how big of a problem it really was.
Wow, that's great, Claire. You know, you've been a lot of help. I really appreciate you talking to me about this.
Yeah.
But can you help me out with one more thing?
I can try. What?
My math homework?
Yeah, we got to finish that. Okay,
yeah, okay,
come on.
Okay.
Yeah, let's go to the library, okay?
All right, thanks. I'll follow you, okay?
Bye, everyone.